For Comedy Hype News, I'm Dom Smith. This week, Aries Spears and Mike Epps would share opposing views on how police shootings should be dealt with. The men would respond to two recent shootings of black men. On one end, Epps would express that he thinks black-on-black crime gives police a reason to shoot blacks, in which Aries would respond and disagree, calling Epps' statement irresponsible. Well, now Epps looks to have caught Spears' comments, and from research, he did not take it well. As Aries would reveal that Epps would angrily call him and began to challenge Spears to a boxing match, and as stated by Spears would imply that he should watch out.
Mike Epps just called me just now. And I said, what's up, Mike? And first of all, let me emphasize again, I got nothing but love and respect for Mike Epps. I really do. I recognize he's an amazing talent. Which one do you want to be? And I just told you this just now on the phone. Do you want to be Dr. King or are you DMX? Because you're sending out mixed messages, which was my whole point to you in the first place. You talking about black people, you need to unite. We need to stop fighting each other and killing each other. But yet you called me. It was nigga this, nigga that. You angry, you yelling. You telling me we should go to the boxing gym, no guns, but we should fight it out. And what you want to call, and you text me, said I'm the police. Talking about I'm snitching. No, I'm not snitching. But I want to let people know, come on, dog, you can't have it both ways. Now, even if we agree to disagree, we should be able to come together as men and have a conversation. To those of you who say, well, Aries, y'all shouldn't air what you're doing on social media. Y'all should talk personally. Well, social media is a public platform. And when you say things publicly and you put out narratives that are dangerous to us as a community and misinformation publicly, then you should have every right to be checked publicly.
Just before Spears' latest reveal, Epps would share a lengthy message on Facebook apologizing for his original statement and would go on to further explain his position, in which he ends by captioning, "We can meet anytime, no guns, just a good old ass whooping." First of all, I want to apologize if anyone misunderstood what I said about killing us, and that's why the cops kill us. The point I was trying to make was this. Before I even knew I was funny or gonna be famous, this picture right here, I was 17 years old, young, wild, ignorant, and didn't care about nothing or nobody. I was selfish and I almost put my family in harm trying to fit in and be accepted in the underworld, until I realized that I was just gonna be a statistic. But I had the individual power to keep myself out of harm's way by being conscious of my actions. We didn't have Instagram in 1987, but we had other influences. I'm speaking from experience. These other dudes in showbiz that been challenging me on how smart they are over me are speaking from text or some rap song or rapper they love. You can hear it in their voice. What I was trying to say in that post was that some police are already out here looking for that. So if we know that, we have to be careful in our everyday steps out here in these streets. I know it's not fair, but unfortunately, if you're black, you have to move different in this country or you're dead or in jail. That don't make you weak. Just know you gotta adjust in this world to survive. Let's not make it so easy for them. When you are wild and do crazy shit, you make it hard on all of us. They only see one thing, and that's black. You can be a black college student or a black drug dealer. They don't know until it's over what kind of black person you are. It makes it hard for us to march and preach justice when we have bad examples in our race. I was one of them before. Again, I'm sorry for the misunderstanding. I love my black people no matter what. I'm just here to do what God put me on this earth to do, and that's make you laugh. Not war with black men on who was right or wrong about a world we can't control that's just been the way before we got here. P.S. I'm against black-on-black crime, but a good old fair boxing match won't hurt nobody but you. No guns, just a good old ass-whooping. Let's go IG live on that. Now for some, Epps' comments appear to contradict his original statement on wanting to see black people loving on each other more by publicly wanting to fight Aries in a ring, as well as calling Spears angrily with his warnings.
It's like when Malcolm X said, you can't have the rapist blame the rape. So come on, man. And that is a very valid point. And to somehow suggest that black people are responsible for their own murder by what we do in our community is insane. Those are two different separate conversations. Okay? And Mike, I tried to call you twice to work it out on Instagram Live, as we agreed to. You didn't answer my calls. So that we can squash this. It ain't no beef as far as I'm concerned. My stance, I'm holding my stance firmly. You put it out in public so you can be checked in public. And as far as being called a snitch, fuck with me, because I ain't no snitch. What I'm doing is exposing your hypocrisy. Which is it? Do we love each other, respect each other, and keep it cool? Or is it all about, nigga, watch out, the streets is gonna get you? Which is it, Mike?
One user would point out the ridiculousness over the whole thing between Epps and Spears by commenting, "This is disturbing to see strong black brothers who are extremely talented arguing about the same thing." Y'all are literally saying the same thing. If y'all just listen to each other, communication is key. Over the weekend, Aries would share that he and Epps were originally supposed to have a healthy conversation over the matter on Instagram Live, but Epps would be a no-show after they agreed. Let's talk about it more in the comments below. What should Spears and Epps do regarding the matter, and who do you think has a better outlook on the topic? And for more news and comedy, stay up to date with the latest news and comedy by subscribing here to our YouTube channel and follow Comedy Hype across all social media. For Comedy Hype News, I'm Dom Smith.